Dear friends, let us discuss carbohydrate deficient transferrin, which is a marker of chronic alcohol consumption. First of all, I want you to know this fact. All the plasma proteins in humans are glycoproteins except albumin. Albumin does not contain any covalently linked oligosaccharide chain, right? Transferrin is a glycoprotein. What type of glycoprotein it is? There are three types of glycoproteins: N-linked, O-linked, and GPI anchored glycoprotein. Look at the structure of transferrin. Can you tell me what type of glycoprotein it is? You see that oligosaccharide chains are covalently attached to the amide nitrogen of asparagine here. So it is a N-linked glycoprotein. You can see that the oligosaccharide chains are branched. That is the property of glycoprotein. In proteoglycan, the carbohydrate portion is linear and there will be a disaccharide repeat in proteoglycans. But in glycoprotein, the oligosaccharide chains are short, but they are highly branched. In glycoproteins, sialic acid is most of the time the terminal sugar. Okay. So it is always the last sugar in the glycoprotein. So this is sialic acid. Okay. Now you should understand one term, glycoforms. Glycoforms are isoforms of a protein that differ just by the glycosylation pattern. That means the protein portion will be same, but the pattern of glycosylation, the pattern of oligosaccharide chain will be different. How? Like this. See this. These are the glycoforms of transferrin. We are seeing that the protein part is same. It's not different. What is differing? It is the number and pattern of oligosaccharide. In asilotransferrin, you are not seeing any sialic acid or any oligosaccharide chain. In disilo, you are seeing the 2-sialic acid. I told you, right? Sialic acid is the terminal sugar in the glycoprotein. Okay. So here you see 2-sialic acid. Here you see 1. So it is monosilo. It is tetra, hexa, penta, and tri. It's clear, right? Among these glycoforms, asilotransferrin, disilotransferrin are known as carbohydrate deficient transferrin. Okay. Normally, the level of asilotransferrin and disilotransferrin are less than 1.6% of total transferrin. Okay. When will we say that the person is suffering from carbohydrate deficient transferrin increase? When disilo and asilo forms are more than 6% of the total transferrin, right? I told you that CDT is a marker of chronic alcohol consumption. How alcohol causes this? Alcohol or its metabolites inhibit glycosyl transferases. So glycosylation, what is glycosylation? It is the enzymatic addition of oligosaccharides. What is glycation? It is the non-enzymatic addition of carbohydrates to proteins, right? So alcohol and its metabolites inhibit the glycosyl transferases. So we are not getting the mature oligosaccharide chain. Moreover, there is induction of sialidases. Sialidases are the enzymes which remove, hydrolyze sialic acid in the terminal portion. So because of this, we are getting disilo and asilo glycoforms of transferrin. Clear? CDT is a marker of chronic alcohol intake more than 60 gram per day. If the person stops drinking, the CDT levels will decrease. But if they start drinking again, the level will once again increase. That is why this is a useful marker for chronic alcohol consumption, and it is also a mark for relapse. Persons who are under therapy, okay, so people go for behavior therapy, okay, sometimes they can relapse, okay. In certain countries also, medico-legally, they measure CDT for chronic alcohol consumption, right? What are the techniques to detect CDT levels? High performance liquid chromatography, that is HPLC, capillary electrophoresis, and isoelectric focusing. Isoelectric focusing separates protein based on their isoelectric pH. Different glycoforms of transferrin have different isoelectric pH, that is why we can detect. So isoelectric focusing is a technique that can differentiate different post-translational modifications of protein. Okay, this is an important point. So post-translational modifications of a protein can be detected by isoelectric focusing. Which is the best technique to detect post-translational modification? Then the answer will be mass spectrometry. Okay, that is the best technique to detect post-translational modification. Isoelectric focusing can also detect post-translational modification. Clear? Sometimes in non-alcoholic persons also, the level of CDT can be high. So we call this as false positive condition. This can happen either due to genetic defect altering glycosylation or certain hepatic diseases which are due to other than alcohol, like hepatocellular carcinoma, chronic hepatitis C, primary biliary cirrhosis. What are the genetic defects altering glycosylation? There is a condition known as congenital disorder of glycosylation. Here, the capacity to glycosylate the protein itself is affected. Okay, here alcohol is not affecting. It is the genetically affected condition. Even hereditary fructose intolerance and galactosemia, they can also alter the glycosylation pattern. So in this condition, you get false positive result for CDT. You have to remember this. Now, let us review the indirect markers of alcohol abuse. Okay, in exam, if they ask you, go for gamma-glutamyl transferase if it is there, and carbohydrate deficient transferrin, it is there. Okay, MCV is also a marker. These two are non-specific marker. Okay, so the specific markers are GGT and CDT. Okay, beta-hexosaminidase, it is also an indirect marker of alcohol abuse. What are the direct markers of alcohol abuse? They are ethyl glucuronide and ethyl sulfate. How are they produced? You know, alcohol is ethanol, CH3CH2OH. In our body, alcohol is conjugated with glucuronic acid. Okay. So once it is conjugated to glucuronic acid, that is ethyl glucuronide, once it is sulfated, the donor of sulfate group is PAPS. Okay, remember I have explained this in xenobiotic class. So you sulfate ethanol to get ethyl sulfate. So these are the direct markers of alcohol abuse. Okay, their role is in medico-legal procedures where they want to measure the direct intake of alcohol. Clear? So I hope I have made my point clear. So with this, we conclude this video.